Test. Christmas Day is a day of happiness for some and a burden for others. People usually celebrate it for the sole reason of family gatherings, gift giving, and cherishing the birth of the Messiah. But what is it really about? Christmas has a more evil and twisted history than you may think. For starters, Yeshua wasn't really born on December 25th. There would have been no way because the climate of Judea was considered to be cold and rainy. How would a baby be able to lay in a manger in the cold? Also, since it was in the winter, the shepherds would have found shelter for their flocks at night.
And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night.
This shows that their flock were out in the fields during this time. Also, many historians and articles claim that the shepherds only let their flocks roam between the months of early April to October in Judea. Another point about Christmas is that it has very Babylonian and paganistic backstories. One backstory would be about the festival of Saturnalia. This festival was celebrated from December 17th to December 25th, and it was derived from ancient Romans. It also came from the ancient farming-associated rituals of the midwinter and winter solstice. Saturnalia included the practice of offering gifts or sacrifices to the gods during the winter sowing period. They celebrated by decorating their houses with wreaths, singing, socializing with family, and having feasts. Schools, jobs, and courts were all closed for the celebration. The whole festival basically worshipped the Roman pagan god Saturn, who was the god of agriculture and time. That sounds really familiar to Christmas, doesn't it? Maybe not the sacrificing part, but the celebration of it all does. Another topic would be the idea of Nimrod and his son Tammu. Actually, Nimrod was the founder of Babylon, as explained in Genesis 10:8-10, which says,
"And Cush begat Nimrod. He began to be a mighty one in the earth. He was a mighty hunter before Yahweh. Wherefore, it is said, even as Nimrod, the mighty hunter before Yahweh. And the beginning of his kingdom was Babel, and Erech, and Akkad, and Calneh, in the land of Shinar."
Nimrod married his own mother, whose name was Semiramis. He eventually died, and Semiramis told the folks people that his spirit had taken possession of the sun. She then told them to give recognition to him and worship him. Eventually, she had a baby and named him Tammu. Since she had a sinful and impure spirit, she went around telling everyone that her baby was a reincarnation of her husband/son Nimrod. Through her teaching this, the doctrine of reincarnation came about. Tammu was born on December 25th, and people eventually started to worship her son since he was the son of a god. Keep in mind, this was a centuries before Christmas became Christianized and Jesus came into play. Last but not least, in the Bible it talks about groves and trees.
"Hear you the word which Yahweh speaks unto you, O house of Israel. Thus says Yahweh, learn not the way of the heathen, and be not dismayed at the signs of heaven, for the heathen are dismayed at them. For the customs of the people are vain, for one cuts a tree out of the forest, the work of the hands of the workman with the axe. They deck it with silver and with gold, they fasten it with nails and with hammers, that it move not."
In verse 2, it immediately states not to learn the way of the heathen. A heathen is someone who doesn't acknowledge Yahweh or believe he exists. That could mean they follow pagan deities instead. As we have seen, Christmas has a lot of pagan backstories behind it. It then goes into saying the customs of the people are vain, and then specifically talks about cutting a tree down and decking it with silver and gold. When we get Christmas trees, most of them come from the woods, if they're real, and we then put ornaments, tinsel, and deck it out with more shiny things. It would be considered to be an idol as well. Christmas may have been changed to Yeshua's birth, but we know that he wasn't born at that time. You can't ignore the origin of something because that's usually where the information comes from. As we see, most of the traditions of Christmas came from the festival of Saturnalia and other pagan observances.
Deuteronomy chapter 12, verses 28 through 32. Observe and hear all these words which I command thee, that it may go well with thee and with thy children after thee forever. When thou dost that which is good and right in the sight of Yahweh thy Elohim, when Yahweh thy Elohim shall cut off the nations from before thee, whither thou goest to possess them, and thou succeedest them, and dwellest in their land, take heed to thyself, that thou be not snared by following them, after that they be destroyed from before thee, and that thou inquire not after their gods, saying, how did these nations serve their gods? Even so will I do likewise. Thou shalt not do so unto Yahweh thy Elohim, for every abomination to Yahweh which he hateth, have they done unto their gods, for even their sons and their daughters they have burnt in the fire to their gods. What thing soever I command you, observe to do it, that thou shalt not add thereto, nor diminish from it.